Hi everyone, welcome to sunny Queensland. We are away on holidays and we are at our rental house where we've come away. Today is our last day and then tomorrow we go back to our brother's place in Brisbane before returning to Sydney the next day. So I'm going to make my first proper Roxy Journal of Stitchery video, volume 3, Down the Garden Path video from Queensland. So the first thing I want to show you is Rach and I decided to do some painting of fabric to try and get some different types of fabrics that we can use in our garden path project. So this fabric, actually, I don't know if you can see the color so well. I'm outside, but I'm kind of in a shaded area. But it's actually, if I hold it up to the camera, it's actually more of a pale aqua blue, which is the most beautiful color. But we were aiming for green. So it looks a bit white in the screen that I'm looking at, but hopefully you can see the colors and the variations. So we had a play around with some different fabrics. Most of these bits here, that's a bit of a darker blue, if you can see the tones. It's not as white as it looks. It is actually an aqua blue. Was meant to be green. These bits here were just a double bed white sheet that I found at Vinnie's for $5. Okay, so I got some darker bits on this one. We did use some blue paints, but most of the paints we used were green. So you can see some darker bits there. And just in case you're wondering how we did this, we literally just used really watered down acrylic paints and just slopped it all over and mopped it up. And Rach used some ferns from the garden because I didn't get any paintbrushes to put some different color blotches on. Sorry, it sounds like the garbage truck is collecting the rubbish. Garbo in Australia, teaching you a bit of Australian language. Okay, so I am actually, these are sort of a minty green, aquary minty green, so I am going to use some of these in my project. They're all the vintage sheet bits. And then I'm not sure what type of fabric this is, but it's a very thin, a very thin fabric, and I've got some green tinges on that as well. I'm going to use some of that. So here's a bigger bit of it, which has come out lovely, and I love the crinkle look. And then this came out really well. This was some sort of scrunched up calico. And we also used some tea. Don't know if you can see the tones in the video, but there are some tea tones. We were dipping in tea, we were dipping in paint. We were just having a bunch of fun. We will do some more when we get back to Sydney, when I've got more of my paint supplies. And I do want to do some more green. So this is one that I did. I dyed that's more green. I've got a couple of little bits of that here. I didn't bring them all with me. I should have. They were the ones I did in the previous video where I used the RIT liquid dye. So I want to do some more of that dyeing because that's more the kind of tones I want to have. So they will go into my garden project. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I'm starting. So you should have watched Rach's prompt first because Rach's video first because she has released the prompt. So the first prompt is wildflowers. So we're going to do some wildflowers. Well, very loud. I think they're picking up the recycling. That sounds like glass bottles. Okay, I'm actually outside. I'm in the shade. But I'm by the pool, so the pool's just next to me. I'm going to go in there after I've done my video because it's super hot. It's like 32 degrees today, and it's only early in the morning. What time is it? It is 8:30 in the morning. It's really hot already. So this cotton, it's actually, I think it's a cotton wool blend. It's very thin. You can see my hand through it. You can see the print of the tablecloth through it. I picked this up at the sewing basket. So I don't know exactly what type of fabric it is, but it feels like a cotton wool blend, and I like it for this project. Number one, it's a neutral color. It's just like a pale creamy off-white color. And number two, because it's thin and I will have lots of layers. So this is my base fabric. Okay, hang on, just got a few loose threads I'm pulling off. So I have ripped it from selvage over to the other selvage, over that way to the other selvage, and it is 8 inches, which fits within the height of my spool. Now my project is going to be running, I'll bring it the other way. My project, this selvage, is going to be the side, is going to be running from left to right, okay, this way. So my garden will go along the fabric. Rach's, as you've seen in her video, is going to be vertical, so it's going to run from top to bottom. So we thought we'd do it differently, just to give you different ideas. You don't have to do it one way or the other. The only measurement you need at the moment, and you don't even need to measure, is just the distance between your spool, which is that for me. So I think my spool measured, I think it was around 9 inches or just under 9 inches, and I've done it 8 because I know I will get some bulk across the top and bottom, because I will go off the edge sometimes with lace, sometimes with bits of fabric. So I'll give myself a little bit of wiggle room. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to start my project right on the end. I'm going to come in a bit and start here. It just gives me a bit of room to, I can add to it. I might want to have that to wrap around my spool. I'm not sure yet. So I'm going to leave myself a bit. I'm not measuring it. I'm just going to approximate around 6 inches. That will definitely get around my spool. Okay, and don't worry about the length of your fabric, because you can add to it. Okay, I'm going to show you what I mean by adding to it. So this is something I've been doing for our other project. I've been working on this recently. I never did the belly band for Roxy's Journal of Stitchery Volume 2 for my Christmas journal. So I'm making a belly band, which will be a wrap around the outside of my book. So this is something I've been working on. I'm not finished. Okay, but I'll give you a look because you haven't seen it. So it's Christmassy themed. Still got work to do, and I want to do a lot more embroidery on it. Okay, in the end I haven't done much yet. So all I did was piece down some bits and pieces of fabric in the background and canthus stitch them down, and then I've added more interesting elements on top. Now I'm showing you this because right there I've joined some fabric, and over here I have as well. So all I've done is overlaid the fabric by about an inch and just done some running stitch to attach more fabric. So that's why you don't need to know your length, because you can keep adding as you want to. Okay, so what I'm going to do with this is, I thought I'd use some of the hand-dyed greeny minty bluey fabric that we made. Okay, just moving it over. I've got a very weird filming setup. I don't have my tripod. I didn't think to bring it. My tripod, my arm that I normally put my iPad on to film. So literally the iPad is up on a chair with a box on it so it doesn't fall off, and I'm filming off the edge of a chair. Okay, so what I'm doing here is, I've left approximately 6 inches. Approximate, and I've laid out, oops, sorry, bumped the chair. I've put down my green fabric. I'm going to pin that in place, and then I'm just going to invisible stitch that down. So my base is ending up with two layers. You've got your base white fabric, and then I've put some of the dyed green fabric on top. And my plan is to add all the texture and the imagery and the wildflowers for this fortnight's prompt on top. So in today's video, I will go off camera and I will stitch this down. Then I'm going to come back and I'm going to use lots of this yummy hand-dyed stuff that I've done in the past. Laces and trims and ribbons and things. I want to create lots of lovely texture. Especially, I love this. Okay, the cheesecloth that I've dyed with brown and green. You'll get lots of yummy texture with that. And I'm going to build up basically my garden background. And I want to do all that first, and then I want to put my wildflowers in there. And as for my path, you don't have to do a path that runs out throughout it. It could just be your garden. I'm thinking of doing a little pebble path, like a little cobblestone path. So I'm not sure how it will be. I haven't decided that yet, but I will have my path that just meanders down through my garden. All right, so I'm going to pop the camera off and I will stitch down my background fabric, and then I'm going to come back and show you how I'm going to layer up some texture. See you soon. Hi, welcome back everyone. So I'm actually on day two because I did this stitching yesterday. I just did little stitches all over the fabric to keep it down because you're not going to see much of it. So it doesn't matter how the stitches look. So what my plan was, I want to create my field for all my flowers, my wildflowers, to be embroidered into. So my wildflowers will be embroidery. And so I'm filming outside again. We're actually in Brisbane now. We've come down from the Sunshine Coast where we were yesterday, or at my brother's place before we return to Sydney tomorrow. And I wanted to build up my field. So I'm just lying down things. They're gonna blow a bit in the breeze, but you'll get the idea. Where I'm laying down all the different bits and pieces of hand-dyed trims and laces and cheesecloth and things like that. And my plan will be to stitch them in place, so it's going to be like a field. So I'm just getting bits and pieces from the side. Hopefully I'm on screen and you can see everything. This cheesecloth kind of stuff that's dyed with greens and brown, this is going to be my go-to because this will give lots of lovely texture in the background. I'm not fussed about how wide I go with this because with the prompts, you can literally do the prompts where you want. So you might do your wildflowers at the start, and then later on there's another prompt that you think would go in nicely with your wildflowers, so you come back and add something else. So it's not like our previous projects where we did block by block and you had a prompt on each block. With this, it's your garden, so you might end up with two or three prompts in one space, or you don't have to keep them in order. Okay, so I have left my bit of fabric at the start. I might decide to extend it the other direction because I think that I want to add something that way. So my garden is just going to continually grow horizontally, left or right, doesn't matter. Just depending on what I feel like. So I'm just going to play around with these so you can get an idea of what I'm doing in when I'm placing my bits of fabric and lace. And then once I feel like I like my design, I'm going to start stitching it all down. So I won't stitch one piece at a time. I'm going to stitch the whole lot down in one go. I love this one. It's one of my favorites. You would have seen me use it many times. So it might look a little bit funny at the moment, but I'm building up my field. Just gradually building up. This cheesecloth is the best. I'm going to have to dye some more because I feel like I'm going to be using it all the time. I might put all the bits of cheesecloth down. Just gives it texture. And I want to generate texture. Almost like they're different paddocks all coming on top of each other. So what have we been up to? We've been pretty busy. We've just been away for almost a week up on the Sunshine Coast. Really beautiful for anyone who lives up here. We stayed in Mooloolaba and we went to Maroochydore. We had dinner there and we went up to, is it Sunshine Beach? Is that right, Mum? Sunshine Beach? Yes, Mum said yes. We went up to the surf club there for lunch. Jamie has spent a long time in the water swimming. I think yesterday he had four swims, two at the beach and two in the pool. He is what we call a water baby, does not get out of the pool. And we're at my brother's now. We arrived here back here this morning and we've all had a swim because it's very hot today. So what did we do, Mum? You can speak.
Went to Virgin Beach.
Perigian Beach we went to. Mum's not talking loudly. Perigian Beach. And had a look around. There was one shop there, had beautiful things, but the prices were insane. Like a linen tablecloth was $1,200. Rach could get them in Italy for probably €5. Seriously, it was ridiculous, the prices. I just don't think that they do a lot of business. They were outrageous. Like a necklace, which was really beautiful. Apparently it was made in Italy. Was pretty, but it was old bits of like doily. Just cut out little bits, like maybe you cut out the flower there and bits and pieces, and then it was stitched onto like either a plaited or a crocheted cord with, you know, a few little beads here and there. It was nothing special. It looked beautiful, but nothing amazing, and it was like $300. I'm like, what? Everything in there, like just one single linen napkin was $45, just for one. So yeah, a lot of people looking in there, didn't see anyone buy anything because it was so expensive. Just yeah, not worth it. Can find those things much cheaper elsewhere. So we are back to driving back to Sydney tomorrow. Mum's flying back. Lucky mum. She doesn't have to come in the car. It's because I can't fit everyone in my car. We've got 6 people. So it would be, I do have a little, what we call a dicky seat in the back. Little booster seat, but it's really designed for younger kids, not for adults. So our teenagers, Lulu and Jamie, are more like adult size. Well, Jamie's the biggest in the car. He's tall. It's not designed for adults. So mum's flying back, and then Rach, Steph, Lulu, Jamie and myself, we're all driving back tomorrow. It's a big drive. What are we looking at? About 10 or 11 hours or something. So, and the cat, my cat Bobby, she's coming back with us too. She'll be happy. She'll finally get to go. She's been living basically in a room for a week. She'll be happy to be home where she can actually go outside. She's a very good traveler. She sits quietly in the car. You don't even hear her, and she just chills out the whole way home. She's very good. Not sure if I want to place this one somewhere. We'll see. So you can see I'm playing around, putting in bits and pieces, layering up like a field. Like when I stitch, I can even pull bits up a bit higher. We'll see. And then what I was thinking of doing is with some of my pretty threads, like, you know, this kind of thing. I've got quite a lot of green. So if you saw my photo I posted on Facebook and Instagram, I will couch down some threads as well. And this one is quite a long one. Across the bottom there. Okay, so it looks a bit wacky, I know, but I think it will look okay once everything's stitched down. So what I'm thinking of doing is just trying to keep it all fairly flat, and I can move things around and manipulate them, bunch them up, shift things around as I go. I'm going to stitch this down using, this is a very fine crochet thread. Seeing if you can see that, and it's a variegated green, so I'm going to use that. And just do little stitches everywhere until I feel like everything is solid. I'll show you how I do a little bit of stitching, then I'll turn off the video, go and stitch it all down, and I'll come back and show you what it's looking like, and show you how I'll add in some of the extra trims. And then to incorporate the field flowers will be growing out of these fields. These are all fields. So they'll be embroidered flowers that I'll be adding them later. Okay, so like I said, everything's not pinned down, so it could shift around. Just seeing if I'm a little bit off screen. Let me move over this way a bit further. Okay. Again, I've got a very strange filming setup. I've got the iPad on a stool and the stool is on the table. So I'm just going to do little stitches just to lock things down in place. So I'm doing a very tiny little running stitch. So small stitch at the top, big stitch underneath. If I wanted my stitch to be even more invisible, I could use a thinner cotton, like just a sewing machine cotton. All right, so hopefully I'm on camera for you. Just a small stitch, and I'm going to do this all over it. Not necessarily in lines, but where I feel I need to lock something down, I'll do a small stitch over it. So this would be better if I did this where it wasn't windy. But anyway, I'm gonna start, come back and lock this one down. And as you, because this is all layered, as you get one piece locked down, you're often locking down something else that's underneath it. Sorry, I've slipped off camera. Let me put myself back up. You can't see what I'm doing. At the moment, I'm just locking this trim across the bottom. Just the bottom part. And then if I need to lift it up, I can. If I want to slot something under it, I can lift the top part up. Just thinking these stitches are a bit big, I'm going to try and make them a bit smaller. Better. All right, so small stitches, I'll lock it all down. I'm going to turn off the video and I'll do some more stitching on this and I'll come back and show you how it's going. See you soon. So here we are, sorry, wobbly camera action. Here we are with the final product. Well, probably not the final product, but a work in progress. I've stitched down a lot of different bits and pieces. The color's not great on the video. It's a bit more nicer colors of green because I'm filming at night. But this is the start of my field where my wildflowers are going to go. So I hope you are enjoying the first prompt and I look forward to seeing what wonderful creations everyone comes up with. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week with some wildflowers. Bye.